I feel like there's always three sides to a story. Mm-hmm. That story, the friend story, and the truth. We don't ever know what happens when they shut that door, go to sleep at night, and they close that bedroom door. A lot of people, oh, I don't want to look insecure, so I'm going to allow anything. Fuck that. Hey guys, this is Kian.
Hey,
so, you know, we trying to make sure y'all, you know,
stay in the know.
Comments down below. Leave a comment and let us know how we can improve. Mm-hmm. We're trying to build our community, our real community, all that good jazz. So, everything is in the description box. If we have anything that we discuss, anything like that, it'll be down there. And you can follow us on all our social media platforms in the description box.
Right.
So, whatever, put that little disclaimer out there.
To pick out our baby. See, yeah. But we're not talking about that kind of baby. We're talking about, we're not going to say what kind yet, but we are on our way to the, to go see the litter to pick the one that we want.
You will see later what we're talking about.
Right.
Little snippet of the baby.
So, the topic at hand that I want to talk about is boundaries, because she had to teach me a lot about that, like coming into this relationship. Okay, the first question is, do you guys feel like boundaries should be the same 50-50, or are there certain things that I guess would make it uneven?
What do you mean? Like, is there certain boundaries that I've set?
Absolutely.
Listen. Okay, so I'm big on setting boundaries on things that make me feel uncomfortable, mm-hmm. things that don't make me feel loved, you know, stuff like that. I feel like everyone should know themselves enough to be like, hey, babe, if you do X, Y, and Z, this mm-hmm. made me feel uncomfortable. So if you cross this boundary, this what how I may react.
Right.
So has there been anything
so I've done that's so kind of I do reasonable? I do feel like boundaries should be 50-50. Whatever you expect whatever you expect the person to do for you, as far if you're putting it out there like, hey, don't do this because this makes me feel this way, that person shouldn't do that either. No matter, even if you say you don't, even if you haven't put that boundary out there, I still feel like common sense will say, well, not even common sense, because you know, common sense ain't common. Yes, but sir. But yeah, so I do feel like it should be like said, like, hey, since you don't want me doing this because it makes you feel this way, I feel like it should be the same way. Coming into this relationship, she did have certain boundaries that she put out there, and I had to work on how to, like, you know, understand, like, hey, this is why, this is, you know, where she's coming from or whatever. But certain things that she expected of me, because I did not say
shit.
Oh shit. Because I did not say, hey, you don't want me to do this, so you don't do that, she would always be like, oh, well, you didn't put that boundary out there. I'm like, you put that boundary out there, so it should have, it should be 50-50.
So this
and Ryan, she didn't even know I was going to talk about this mm-hmm. today, but I just felt like I wanted to.
I feel like Breon, and she speaks up when need to, but in a relationship and love when she doesn't. And right. You know, the stranger, she gonna do what she do, but she basically, like, family or someone she loves, she's gonna take the back seat. So when I tell her that there were certain things, okay, she never laid out boundaries. I'm one of that. If right. you guys have watched all the videos, I'm up front. I'm forward. Like, it's just, so I say, hey, what are some of your boundaries in a relationship? Oh, basically, I just go with the flow. To me, that lets you know anything goes until you say something. I treat you the way I be treated, but the same way, she always said, I'm a different person. And I was like, is this your, when I asked Bree what are her boundaries on certain things, meaning, hey, is it cool for me? And this is not something that I do. A boundary when I tell her, like, hey, so is it okay for me to talk to someone I used to talk to or had sexual relations with? For me, I flat out let you know, hey, I don't like that. That makes me feel uncomfortable. I don't like to not, I don't like that. And so that's a boundary. So her argument is saying, well, if you expect that, you should expect for me not to do that too. Well, and she always clarifies that I'm a different person. A lot of stuff that I set boundaries for, she says she's never met someone like that. Mm-hmm. And therefore, I can't assume that you're going to think like me and think that's okay. Therefore, until you verbally let me know, hey, this is a boundary of something that I do, I don't think that's, you know, I don't think that's fair, because you always, Bree always lets me know, hey, you think different. It's not wrong with that. Right. But she never knows that. So for her to be like, oh, well, you should think like that, I don't think it's fair, because she's never met no one like me. A lot of people don't have boundaries. So she's been around a lot of people who just goes with the flow.
I do. I have friends that are in relationships, and they both still talk to people they've been with. Like, you know, they're still friends with exes, or even people that they just like was like a random fuck, whatever. I always felt like if there was no feelings there, like, I don't really care. Like, I can still, you know, talk to you or whatever. But I had to understand, remember how we were talking about love language? It's like, you can't love somebody or treat somebody the way that you expect it. You gotta, like, see how they want to be treated, and that's how you move. I understand, like, that those were boundaries for her. But I had to also let her know that if you have these boundaries, it needs to be 50-50. You can't say, oh, you can't do that, but I can do that, because you didn't set that boundary. That's not fair. So I did have to, like, we had to have those, like, hard discussions, and she had to, like, understand where I was coming from as well. So now we are on a 50-50 boundary.
Because, A, she's never been with anyone like me. I've never been with no one like her.
There were no boundaries set in any relationship that I was with in. It was just kind of like, okay, well, you know, of course you love the person, so you don't cheat, you don't flirt, you don't, you know, you don't do certain things.
It's just basic stuff, but
people would still do that, you know what I mean? Because it's like, you can't even say outside of boundaries. It's just like, you know, you think it's common sense, but sometimes people don't even feel that way. Like, in order, they feel like they're not flirting, or they feel like they're not being disrespectful, whatever the case may be. But if you're okay with your significant other, like, talking to other people or doing whatever, that's your preference. Because, like I said, I do have friends of mine who their relationships are great, and they work fine that way. But you know,
to appearance, I feel like there's always three sides to a story. Mm-hmm. That story, the friend story, and the truth. And yeah, on the outside, we don't ever know what happens when they shut that door, go to sleep at night, and they close that bedroom door on, hey, because I've seen a lot of people, oh, I don't want to look insecure, so I'm going to allow anything. But, like, let me tell you something. I ain't no way in hell, if anybody go, I tried to be civilized in this video, but I cannot. It's no way in hell, if anybody don't have any dealings with my wife, I'm not gonna smoke hookah with you. Like, you, and guess what? If you was a friend, you probably would have still been around. Let me tell you something. As our relationship has blossomed, Bree has kept, now, she, like she said, she's a social butterfly. She has kept a handful of people who's been solid. And with this person, and if they disappear, they weren't solid. So those solid people that's came over, she does have masculine friends, same studs. But guess what? Them studs came out the way and said, hey, bro, what's up? I'm glad you're here. Let's chop it up.
Thanks for making my friend happy. Like,
and then she has another set of masculine friends who just disappeared. So to me, being a player that I used to be, it's an issue. You know what I'm saying? Either you liked her, or you're jealous, or you're mad. That, I don't know. But that's where I come from. Like, she don't ever have to worry about.
Maybe they don't know how to be.
But that's weird within itself.
Because sometimes people can just be like, okay.
Well, I don't have nothing in common with her, because now she married.
No, not nothing in common. But maybe they were just like, you know, I'm not going to like a picture. I'm not going to like reach out to her. I'm not going to do certain things because she's married now. Maybe
that's weird. But everybody knows. If anybody got to know me, they know I'm chill as fuck. I don't care. As long as I'm big on respect. I die for my respect.
You already know, like, how you are.
But if you respect, you know, your good friend that I even text. She ain't respectful.
Now they're building a friendship. I think that's so cute.
But think about it. Mm-hmm. If anybody else came, but anybody else that came respectful, I meet you there.
Right.
You know, you have to be.
I agree.
I meet you there. But if you on some side eye stuff, you done to me from the jump. You know what I'm saying? Right. So boundaries like that, like some these people that was cool with her, they set their own boundaries, meaning, hey, we used to kick it when you was single, doing whatever, but now basically it looks like we don't have nothing in common, so I'm not going to kick it with you or talk to you at all anyway.
Right.
And hey.
Which, that's fine. Like,
sometimes you outgrow people.
Yeah, right.
A single stuff or stuff that you used to do around their significant other because it's awkward. Already, remember when you do this and do that?
It's disrespectful, too.
It's disrespectful.
You're not that same person anymore.
And so there you go. So that's sometimes you those boundaries just come out of nowhere, don't they?
Right. So. Setting boundaries in relationships, like just like an intimate relationship, you have to set boundaries with friendships too, because that's also a relationship. And I had to learn that.
Because friendships, because people sometimes when people in a stagnant place, and say if, because Brista has a lot of friends that's still on a party scene. Sometimes they don't outgrow that party scene. So therefore, you have to let boundaries know. And now some people, and you know what, you do have a point. Some people will just ghost, and then they'll be like you got a message the other day. I don't know if you really party or not anymore. I know you're not on the scene,
but they were having two things. They were having like a birthday party in a club, and then they were having, I love kickbacks. Like,
but we go to things like that.
So they were just like, say, hey, like, I know you don't go to the club like that no more, but I'm also having a kickback. So, you know, you invited to both, but you know, I really want you to come to the kickback or whatever. So, you know, like that was, you know, I know who you are. I love you, boo, like whatever. But, you know, like that was very respectful because I am on a different.
Yeah, you are.
I'm just different now.
You basically becoming a housewife and a mama.
A housewife.
I mean, but like what?
Yeah.
You know? So, I mean, and I'm not forced to do nothing.
I still go out and I still have fun.
We still
kick
it.
Like, I'm still, like, you know, star or whatever, but, like, I'm just more, like, chill now because I am more focused
You representing somebody, too.
And I'm representing you, so it's like, I can't just be out there just acting all crazy. Like, no.
Hell no, I would burn a club down. Like, I don't want my wife, who literally carries my last name, present herself in a way where everybody think they got access to. And just because she having fun and stuff, people are disrespectful. We're in Atlanta. But the thing is, she can go.
You know, I love to dance. Like, I will dance anywhere. Like,
but she know how I am. Like, if she wanted to go out with her friends, cool. But if it's somebody at the woodwork that I haven't seen in years or even talked to or kicked it with, because I don't went to dinner, all kind of stuff with all her day ones. Mm-hmm. Now, if it's somebody random trying to kick it with and they can't even have a conversation, then I'm going to be like, baby, I don't really know about this person. This is brand new. But she know I'm still going to be like, okay, well, let's. I need to know what this person's intentions are because I haven't. I don't know who this person is. Yeah, we just let us know what boundaries y'all have, or have you set, or boundaries that your significant other has crossed, and how did y'all get through it? Because that's a real issue. People don't want to talk about that.
It was so funny because remember, like I was saying, like literally, y'all, my dad, like he would always be like, "Brian, I just want you to slow down. I just want you to slow down. I just want you to, you know, live life.
Ribbon parties, and she loved.
I just want you to travel.
She done had enough partying.
I just want you to travel and just like meet somebody and just be like just you know, slow down. And I was already like on that path of slowing down, like when he got sick and stuff. So I was just like, you know, I think he'll be proud of the, you know, the person I've become. You know, like, you supposed to like live.
You
like,
kicking it in the
I
party.
Lived, okay? Not really.
Yeah.
I'd be like, it's
not
the time.
It is the time. It's always the time. But anyway,
do I ever have to kick your significant other or pinch them or something to hit the table?
Please don't do that.
Let's comment that, please.
We are
choose our baby.
Okay, y'all get to come with us to choose the baby.
Yes.
Y'all ready? Then we're gonna hold the name off for when they
when
come
we go,
home.
Yeah.
They'll be home in a couple of weeks.
Yeah, we're probably gonna do like a 24-hour.
Yes, it's so exciting. So y'all, this is right on time because baby finna have our baby. That's in the works. And then we're gonna anyway. Nope, see what she does. She hangs up.
So, one more red girl. No, we're not. I'm like, my
That's a good one.
How many litters that mama had?
Where are you going?
Hi, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Who does she have? No matter. Yeah, we at 524. And you normally don't eat this late, but pussy out of the movie. If y'all haven't tried pie, y'all trip. And if, I mean, just go try it. It's really good. You eat some packaged noodles at Walmart, you can eat this.
It's my favorite. Oh,
I think we
did
it because
I'm showing the stuff that we put in.
Mm-hmm. She always put that in there, and I always do sriracha. And so we always, we tried, like, when we was, like, eating meat heavy, I guess. We tried the other stuff, but we always get shrimp now. Don't judge me, judge your mama.